The pitch. Carbo hits a high drive. Deep center. Way back. Home run!
I remember the darkness of the stands and the movement in the darkness of the stands. This enormous noise came up. And the game was tied.
That was a blast up in the center field bleachers. It came with two outs and a count 2-2. And the Red Sox have tied it 6-6.
The game was tied, and it stayed that way through the 9th, the 10th, the 11th.
Murphy and Geronimo are shallow.
High fly ball, left field. Foster's got a shot. They're tagging up a third. Here comes the throw. It is in time.
Here's the throw. Foster made the catch in foul territory. He needed a perfect throw to keep the Reds from losing this game. And it was. No question about it. Denny Doyle out at home.
Well hit, right field. Deep. Evans is going back. Back near the wall. And
White Evans went way back. He had no room to go anymore. Watch it. One-handed catch. Big play of the game. And now we go to the bottom of the 11th inning, still tied.
Pete Rose came up to bat in the 10th or 11th inning, and players never do this, do you understand? Players never think about games like this. And he turned to Carlton Fisk and he said, "This is some kind of game, ain't it?"
Carlton Fisk was the leadoff batter in the bottom of the 12th inning.
Here's Fisk.
Game tied, 6-6. Darcy pitching. Fisk takes high and inside. Ball one. Freddie Lynn on deck. There have been numerous heroics tonight, both sides. The 1-0 delivery to Fisk. He swings, long drive, left field. If it stays there, it's gone. Home run! The Red Sox win! And the series is tied, 3 games apiece.
Carlton Fisk in a 1-0 pitch. They're jamming out of the field. His teammates are waiting for him. The ball hit the foul pole, and the Red Sox have sent the World Series into Game 7 with a dramatic 7-6 victory. What a game. This is one of the greatest World Series games of all time.
When Carlton Fisk stood up, I just had this feeling inside, just as I had felt once before with the Brooklyn Dodgers, that something good was going to happen. Usually I feel terrible things are going to happen, but never could I have imagined that sight of his not only hitting the ball, but willing it fair. I think what it represented was just all of us wish we could control our destinies in a way that we can't usually. And the way the whole ballpark was moving with Fisk to will that ball instead of being foul fair was as if you really could make spiritual, magical things happen. And it happened, and it was great.